Hi everyone, this is Shivani here. Welcome to my channel Shivani Creations. Today I am showing you how to create these two beautiful paper quilling Rakhi with the decoupage base. Yes, I have created the base using decoupage technique with the thread base and you will going to love this technique. So let's get started. So first I am taking here 1.5 inches circle punch by Dress My Craft and I am just punching some 300 GSM white cardstock or white sheet using this. If you don't have punch, you can just cut it using rounder. So in total I am taking total 5 circles to create the thick base and I am going to attach all 5 circles together. So this is done. Now I'm taking decoupage thread. You can find this thread easily from any craft store and I'm just start making the coil using my fingers. So after creating little bit of coil, directly you can paste on your base. So exactly in the center I have added glue and I have pasted my coil. Then add glue little and start rotating your thread around the base. So you need to fill whole base using these thread coil. And the base is covered and it's done. Now I'm going to cover the whole base using liquid glue or Fevicol to make it more sturdy. Just spread it thoroughly using brush and allow it to dry completely. So it's dry and it's quite hard now. So it's time to add some color here before doing decoupage. So I'm taking here chalk paint by Little Birdie. I am using in buttermilk shade and since my paper is having the white base, that's why I am using white chalk paint. So just apply the color all over the base. Don't forget to color sides as well. And this is done, allow it to dry. It's completely dried and here I am taking this beautiful floral decoupage paper. I took this paper, I just bought it randomly from some stationery store and I cut the beautiful floral design. Now I am taking my decoupage glue and first I am applying the glue on the base. You can also use Mod Podge. I have given all the supply links in description box. Don't forget to check there if you want to buy anything. So I have applied the decoupage glue. Now I am just removing two plies from the paper and putting the thin printed paper on my base and just dabbing it using sponge to stick it very well. Do it very gently because the paper is very thin, and stick it very well. This decoupage is called three ply decoupage paper. Just stick from sides as well. And now it's done. So I am going to pour some decoupage varnish all over the base. And then here I am taking this beautiful rainbow sparkle dust by Resme Craft and sprinkling it over my base. So just mix it very well with glue and it will give you very nice sparkly rainbow look to your base after drying. And the purpose is mixing it with glue that after drying the dust will not come out. Now I'm starting with my quilling flower decoration. So for my first flower I'm taking 1/4 strip of pink color and I'm making one teardrop shape. For all quilling work I'm using 2mm strips only. In the same way I have created one more teardrop shape. So I'm just joining two teardrops together and wrapping this whole petal using yellow strip. My one strip length is 45 centimeters. So in total I have created total 6 petals and I'm joining all together to create the flower. Before creating flower, I'm just applying little archival ink in plum shade in the bottom part of petal to just give it little shading. If you don't have archival ink, you can also use acrylic colors. Just apply the color in the bottom using brush. And now I'm joining all 6 petals together. For the center of the flower, I have created yellow tight coil which is made using half strip. So flower is ready. Now for the next flower, I'm taking 1/4 strip of yellow color and making one leaf shape. This is a tight leaf shape. I'm joining 4 petals together and adding red color tight coil in the center, which is made using 1/4 strip of red color. Then I'm starting with the leaf. For this I'm taking 1/4 strip of light green and 1/4 strip of dark green and making one leaf shape. Joining two leaves together. And also I have created these tiny scrolls using same colors. If you want to learn how to create scroll, I have given link in description box. You can check there. So all my quilling designs are done. Now taking back my base and here I have created this rakhi thread. So I took one golden thread and added two green silk tassels at the end. Just folding my thread from center so that we will get the center point. And I am taking one pink color circle base. Adding little glue all over this and first put your silk thread on top of this exactly in the center and then I will connect my decoupage base. So it's done. Now on the edge I am adding golden color ball chain just to decorate it. I have already put some glue on the edge and now I am sticking the golden ball chain. Then I will start adhering my flowers and leaves. I'm just putting my flower on my palm and pushing in the center to create a little 3D. And it's done. So first Rakhi is ready. Now I'm starting with the second Rakhi. So I have prepared one more base using different design of decoupage paper with the same procedure. And here again I'm making my Rakhi base. So putting my golden thread on pink paper, adding the decoupage base on top of this. And this time I have added yellow silk tassels at the end. Now I'm starting with my flower. So for first flower I'm taking half strip of yellow color. I have created leaf shape. This is a tight leaf shape and I'm joining total 6 petals together to create the flower. All the shapes are very basic, so I'm not showing you again. And for the center of the flower I'm using pink color tight coil, which is made using half strip of dark pink and 1/4 strip of light pink. And this tiny flower is made using 1/4 strip of light pink, and leaves and scrolls are same as before. Here I have added green color ball chain around my decoupage base. And now I will start arranging my quilling designs. So this is done. So both the beautiful quilled Rakhis with the decoupage base are ready. They are very unique and interesting, and I'm sure you will try this very soon. So my project is done for today. Hope you enjoyed my video. Please subscribe my channel for more interesting videos, and please click on bell icon for the latest updates. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye bye.